Greetings. Today we are going to see how you can create a night scene in DAW Studio. As it is not always you make a day scene, sometimes you want a night lighting. But it is not easy to do so, that is why we made this video. I am going to be using this simple scene to show everything. Here is how it looks rendered with the default lighting settings. From our iRay lighting tutorial, you know that using an HDRI is an easy way to light your scene. So to create a night scene, you just need a nice night HDR image, right? On the HDRI Haven, they even have a night section. Though it seems that most images here are quite bright and does not resemble the night. I like the Sitara night because it does look quite dark and late. Applied it to the scene. And here is how it looks. Very and very dark. You almost can't see the scene itself. What if we make the environment more intense? It just becomes brighter but does not look like it is night. On the HDRI Haven, except for the image that we are using currently, there is also the same scene with some lamps in the distance. Let's try it. I would say that this looks even worse. It is very artificial and yellow, not a night scene at all. So what should we do? What options do we have? Well, there are several ways of creating a night scene lighting, so let's look at some of them. The first one is called the day for night method. It is a very popular method that is used in different media such as movies a lot even today. Its name explains it very well. The essence of this method is when you create a day lighted scene and then make it look like a night scene. To do so, usually, a lot of color grading and different post-production is used. In DAW Studio, the tone mapping part of the render settings is what we need. With the white point being the main one here. Back to this later, now let's create a day-lighted scene. I want to start with something very simple, so let's change to the sun-sky environment mode. Sun-sky simply simulates the sun as the single lighting source for the whole scene. I can control the angle of the sun using settings here. I like the lighting, but it looks way too bright and there are prominent and sharp shadows, which should not be there in the night scene. The SS Sun Disk Intensity controls how shadows will be created. When it is set to zero, there are no shadows at all. Lower the environment intensity. Now to the tone mapping, we will change the white point. White point changes the way white color is displayed and thus, color grades the whole scene. Our goal is to make the scene much bluer. To achieve this, we need to set white point, not to the blue color, but the opposite of it. Confusing, but that is how it works. Yellow and orange colors are what we need. Now the scene has a slight blue tint. People associate this blue tint with night scenes, so that is how we make a day scene into a night scene. If I make white point even more yellow, the scene would be much bluer. Also, you can use other colors for other results. For example, a green white point will provide a purple result. Returning it to something less intense. I think that it looks like quite a night scene. though there are no shadows at all, which can look weird. So to add them, I increase the sun disk intensity a bit and lower the environment intensity to compensate. Also, change white point to a bit more prominent yellow. Now it both looks like a night scene but also had some shadows. The same method can be applied to basically any type of lighting. For example, on the HDRI. This time let's use a daylight HDR image, like this urban street. Without any tone mapping, it looks like this. Need to make it less intense before proceeding. Now I set the white point to the same value it had previously. Easy as that. After this, we will look at something more complex and difficult. I have prepared this scene. It uses the three-point lighting technique that we introduced in one of our previous videos, DAZ Studio iRay Lighting Tutorial. So we have one strong and bit light in front of the character. Second smaller and weaker light to the side. And the weakest and smallest at the back for the highlights. Also, we still have the same HDRI applied, but at very low intensity. Let's look at the scene in the rendered view. It looks bright and warm, not even close to the night lighting. Earlier, we usually just lowered the environment intensity setting before going into color grading. But now it is not as simple, because we have multiple light sources, so we will need to go into each one of them and manually lower the setting. Which is tedious and not very easy to do. Besides, there are cases when you would need these lights later at the initial settings. If we will change the white point as is, the changes to the scene would be minimal. So we need to up the intensity a lot and also make it much more orange because the scene is warmer now. Now it has a blue tint, but it still is way too bright and intense. We will try to fix this without changing the settings of the light sources. Instead, we will use more color grading in the tone mapping menu. Namely, I am talking about the f/stop and shutter speed settings. They control the exposure of the scene, so by increasing both of them, we can underexpose the scene and thus make it darker. A bit too dark, so decreased f/stop some more. We received a dark scene with a blue tint, that very much looks like it was made in the night. Except for these two settings and the white point, there are other useful settings here in the tone mapping that will help you to make the scene better. They all here at the bottom. Burn highlights makes any highlights on the scene brighter and more visible. So lowered it to make the scene even less bright. Crush black setting makes black colors darker and stand out even more, which makes the scene much darker too. I decrease it a bit, so everything would be a bit more visible on the scene. And saturation should be familiar, makes colors more saturated or desaturated than to basic black and white. I also decrease this one, as usually in the night setting colors are not very prominent, instead, they should look washed out. Here is the final look. Reset everything to remind you how the scene looked without color grading. Absolutely different. We can also create a night scene without actually using tone mapping at all. The result would be very similar to that in day for night method. It is done by using light sources only, so turned off the environment map lighting. What we will do is only use the two lights in front and hide the backlight. For the main light, I make it much bigger and change the angle a bit, so it would lightless of the surroundings. Of course, also I need to change lumens to something much lower, so it would not be as bright. For the fill light, I also increase the size, but also decrease the spread angle, so it would be more directed. Additionally, make it much less intense. How does it look? Probably a bit too bright, especially the background. We want it to be dark and not attract attention at all. So I move the main light a lot closer to and even decrease the spread angle a bit. Move the second light closer to. And made them even less bright. This is much better. Character is lighted and is the main point, while the background is not remarkable. Now we can change the temperature of the lights to something a lot colder. And maybe even change the color to a slightly bluish. Here is the rendered look, and remember that we did not use any tone mapping at all for this. Though if we did, it would probably look better. An additional thing that we can do is to add a strong backlight, to make the scene more dramatic and attract even more attention to the main character. Also, we can make the overall scene darker, to emphasize this effect of dramatic lighting. But what about HDRIs? We established that if you use an image with a proper, dark night, it won't work. But on the HDRI Haven, there are a lot of images that are lit differently, maybe they will work? I like the Kloppenheim O2 image. It depicts night but has some bright spots that may work. Let's try it. I won't say that this looks like night, it is bright and has some very noticeable shadows. Decreasing the environment intensity does not help a lot. We can try to improve everything with the tone mapping, but it is not a very genuine result. Overall, HDRIs can work, but they need to be very specific and images like those are quite rare. But they can be very useful as the accommodation to the scene. Meaning that if it is used combined with some tone mapping and spotlights, it definitely can work. I want to talk about other things that may help you with creating a night-lighted scene. On the DAZ3D.com shop, there are plenty of stuff that can help you with this task. For example, you can get a ready scene that is already set in the night. Like iRay DS Lights, Streets of Asia 2 by Night. It is situated on some Asian streets at night. All you need to do is pose your character here and it would be ready. Or another example, Old Village Wishing Well iRay. It is a simple well, but you can see that it looks very good with some night lighting. Also here we can find a lot of very cool HDR images made for DAZ Studio. The Orestes iRay HDRI Skydomes, Darkest Night has some very dark maps. You can see here that you will probably need some additional light sources. So it is closer to real life nights. On the other hand, there are Orestes iRay HDRI Environment, Haunted Grove at night. It is still a night setting, but it is much brighter and we can see all the details clearly. Though for someone it can be too bright. If you want to have a bigger collection to choose from, then Sci Starry Skylights and HDRIs for iRay is a very good choice. It has some very nice images, but most importantly, there are 12 of them, plus different spotlight presets that you can add to. The iRay HDRI Reshade is the one that will make your life a lot easier. It is a tool that allows for reshading your HDRIs. Meaning that you can change the color grading for the background, without changing it to the whole scene. It makes creating a night scene much easier if you are using an HDRI. To learn more about DAZ Studio and 3D design overall, visit renderguide.com. Here we create articles on the different topics that may interest you. Including the DAZ 3D Night Render iRay tutorial. For even more context on the topic. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.